are their existence, their livelihood out of the wilderness with their own two hands. And so young Lincoln and his sister Sarah would have had a tremendous amount of responsibility. Chop wood, farm. It was very rough. Lincoln and his sister would have to rely on each other for so much at such an early age.
His mother, Nancy Hanks Lincoln, was a very beautiful woman.
Lincoln believes that his mother is his angel.
But just as the family begins to settle into their new home, tragedy strikes.
In a period of drought on the frontier, cattle would eat something called snake root. So that gets into the milk.
Lincoln's mother drinks milk that's diseased.
And she gets sick.
And she dies.
Young Abraham helps his father nail his mother into the coffin that will take her away from him for the rest of his life.
From modern psychological studies, we know that if the surviving parent is emotionally available and supportive and nurturant, that the damage done by the other parent's death is largely offset. But Thomas Lincoln does not fit that description.
There's little time to grieve on the frontier. 9-year-old Abraham and his 11-year-old sister Sarah are too young to take on all of their mother's responsibilities. And winter is just around the corner.
Thomas Lincoln needs a woman around the house. You can't do computer dating in this period, and he has to go courting. He picks up and heads to civilization, where there are women folk,
and leaves these two children to fend for themselves.
It was a risk that Thomas had to undertake and was not the first to undertake.
They were practically reduced to animal existence.
Their hair was not cut. They were unwashed. Their clothes were peeling.
This part.
You're at your peril every second living in this environment.
This is hilarious.
That would merit a prosecution and jail time today. It's a remarkable survival story.
Well, what about the black people that were there?
He had to find a way to be self-reliant. He had to find a sense of courage and confidence in who he was, because it's life and death.